All right, so joining me to talk about this now, live from Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, is Dr. John Nkengasong. He's the director of the Africa Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.
So hearing these world leaders, including the Pope as well, calling for more to be done on this huge stage here, what impact is that likely to have, given that they've already pledged, you know, over 1.2 billion doses to COVAX, the International Vaccine Sharing Initiative, but they've only delivered some 150 million?
I mean, absolutely. I think the world, through the World Health Organization, has established a target of immunizing the entire population of the globe up to 70% by end of next year. And during the summit at the White House hosted by President Biden, he also reiterated that target of 70%. So we know exactly what to do. But where we find ourselves as a continent is in a very delicate situation where only about 5% of the population has been fully vaccinated. So now it becomes very clear what we need to do to get from 5% to 70%, which is a daunting task. The key question is, how do we commit or convert those pledges into action? The United States has already donated about 63 million doses to the continent. They have just recently, last week, arranged for the African Union member states to acquire 110 million doses of the Moderna vaccines. That is all very good initiatives, and which is really not necessarily a donation, but allowing African Union member states through the African Vaccine Acquisition Task Team to acquire those doses there. This is exactly the kind of efforts that we should be aiming at, which is about the partnerships, cooperation, and solidarity.
Okay, so you've outlined some of the concrete measures that you need to get to that 70%. I just want to get some more of those, because the G20 announced it would create that task force to fight future pandemics. So from your perspective, what's the priority there? What needs to change the most, the quickest, to prevent the you know, the next inevitable pandemic from getting as bad as COVID has been, or worse?
Now, I think it is the creating a task force to avoid the next pandemic is absolutely important. We fully support that as Africa CDC. But what we are saying is that our house is still on fire. A continent of 1.2 billion people only has 5% of its population immunized. So I think the immediate urgent issue is to address the access to vaccines so that we can immunize our people very quickly, get this pandemic over, then we can discuss how to tackle the next pandemic. So I think my message to the G20 is, let's commit ourselves to the pledges. Let's make the pledges translate to reality, into vaccines, vaccines into people's arms, so that we can get to the target that we've all agreed on. The next pandemic clearly will be there, I hope not, but how we address this pandemic will guide us on the way we address the subsequent pandemics.
So, as you say, access to vaccines is key. There has been some recent good news. BioNTech just announced it'll build a vaccine facility in Africa next year. So would that be a game changer for the continent?
That would be a game changer. I think we are very excited with the news coming out last week, especially with that BioNTech will be producing vaccines next year in Rwanda, Senegal, and other places. That is much welcome. The African Union, through the Africa CDC, has been very clear on this. We have said that from now to the year 2040, we should be able to reverse the situation and be able to manufacture up to 60% of vaccines on that continent. So that is truly going to be a game changer. And in a way that we should factor this into the as instruments for fighting the next pandemic. If we set up these manufacturing facilities, not only are we protecting the continent of Africa, but we are contributing to the global health security agenda. So we welcome those initiatives.
All right. So trying to convince those in wealthy countries, I mean, you could rely on their sense of altruism, or maybe it's more realistic. You can appeal to their sense of self-preservation. I'm thinking just recently a WHO advisor warned that if the vaccine disparity continues, the pandemic could go on for a year longer than it needs to. So if you're here, you're making a case to Americans to say helping the rest of the world is in your best interests as Americans. What do you say?
No, absolutely. I think we know that we are dealing with a virus that transmits very quickly. We're dealing with a virus that mutates very quickly. And because it mutates, it creates variant. We now have seen how even countries that vaccinated at scale, like Israel, were challenged with the emergence of the Delta variant. And we don't want that to happen. We want to be sure that we vaccinate at scale and at speed so that we have the appropriate coverage and avoid that new variants will emerge that will challenge even the current the vaccination efforts there. So I think it's very clear. We have to be humble enough to know to say that we know a lot about this virus, but we still don't know much about it in terms of what how it will mutate and how it will impact the current vaccines there. So it is in a collective interest that we vaccinate everybody across the world and reach that 70% target and blunt the spread of this virus.